My name's Sean, and supposedly somehow I got the title of being the Gadget Man, mainly from my mom telling everybody that, I guess. But my mom's Virgie over here, and let me tell you a little history, I guess, of what started all this, mainly for those of you who don't know me or my mom, was when a few years back my mom had her stroke. And we decided at that point we needed to find some stuff that actually helped her out around the house, like some of the stuff like kitchen items or different things, or some of the other gadgets around the house. Now, for the sake of the show, I've added a lot more here for us so that you can, get a well-rounded idea of different other things that may not necessarily be technically gadgets, but useful aids around the house. Let me put it that way. So I don't want to make it sound like we're going to learn electronics today. We're not. We're just going to learn some good stuff that's helpful around the house that may help in different situations for you. First off, I'd like to thank Debbie Travis and the staff here for allowing us to be here, and thank Carl back here for setting up all the film equipment, and he's filming back here. So when we start out, I'm going to go basically down the aisle here. In the little sections, we're going to do question and answer, so feel free to ask as we go along here. I want to start with probably the worst place to start with, and then we'll get that out of the way first, then we'll move over. One of the issues we had when my mom had a stroke was the house that they were living in at the time, there was no bathroom on the main floor. You had to either go upstairs or downstairs, which, as you know, that's hard for the stroke. Plus, it was an old house, and it had the curved stairwell, so it was even harder. So we considered other options at that time and what we needed to do. So one of the options we had looked into, and we studied a little bit, but we never had to do it because they moved, was camping. Stuff. And the medical equipment or to renovate your bathroom is going to cost several thousand dollars. Or you may not have the space to put those walk-in bathtubs in or different things. So one of the ideas we had considered was like camping showers and camping toilets. And I say this is a much affordable thing, is and they're portable. But for like the shower, I got one of the examples here. That is the, it just hooks into the faucet. And then it makes it, you can sit up a chair outside the bathtub, or, depending on how high it is, you could straddle the legs on the out front. Some of the chairs have the adjustable legs, so you can adjust, in and out of the bathtub, which is nice. That way, you could still get the shower and stuff, but you'd have something lightweight. The camping stuff actually offered a different thing that I wasn't really looking at, but it came across because I didn't bring any of that stuff, was like a pup tent style shower that you could set up too. So if you need like privacy in a back room or whatever. And those are only like $20 or $30. So they're not, outrageously, in price. And it's something that you could set up and still have privacy. Like if you need to, use the corner of a bedroom for, either a restroom or a quick shower. So I share that, just as, because that was one of our weird things that we learned along the way. And I want to start there and move out through the house. So another thing with the bathroom we found out is for us, we had a problem with those not enough handrails or those little grip things. If you get the ones with the suction cups, they're really good on a temporary status. Like so if you fell and broke your arm and you needed something extra help for a couple, a couple weeks or whatever, the ones with the little suction cups are good. If you had something long-term, I'd get the ones that actually screw into the wall. That was, we found that after a little bit, the suction cups popped off. But they're great if you went to travel too. If you went to a hotel or whatever, that's great to take it and throw it in your bag and stick it in the hotel shower so you have that extra handrail. But they didn't last long on the overterm use. So I would suggest if you had to get those, get the ones with the screw ends into the wall instead of the suction cup. Now, another issue we found with the suction cups was the shower mats. They didn't stick to the floor. I don't know if you guys had this, but some of the shower mats have like a glue that stick to the floor, like the suction cups. For some reason, at our place, we have like a grooved bathtub floor, and they don't stay on there. So we found that you have to look for a mat that has little air pockets instead of suction cups. So these little air pockets, when you stand on them, they kind of force little suctions on them. But and they'll stay. They'll stay a lot better than the rest of the stuff. So, and also if you find out, if you got that textured floor, it won't screw up that textured floor. So that's, we had to really look for that. So I'll throw that out. I mean, I could tell you where to get it. And back over there, I got a table with some of the handouts and the flyers that could tell you all that stuff more. So you know, don't worry if you need to take notes, whatever, for that. But like I said, the air pockets ones are what you want that will stick in there. There's like a whole bunch of little, like pushy air pockets that, you know, as you stand on them, they just kind of, you know, stick to the floor without screwing up the floor. Another issue that we came across here was, how do you tell if the water's really hot? And I came across this little guy and I liked it. It's hard to see this, and without making a huge mess around here, because you actually have to screw it to the faucet. But if you take the little tip off your shower faucet and put one of these on, when it gets hot, a red light goes off. So the water looks like a little night light with a red light going through. So you can see it pretty much in your, you know, bathroom sinks or, you know, showers and stuff. You can get them for the shower heads, you can get everything. So it's really nice to have that instead of having to touch the water, or you could, you know, or say how hot, how hot is this and getting burned, you can see the red light. And I went, this little thing was really, really affordable. Most of the stuff up here is very affordable. Yes. This one particularly is called the LED faucet light. I'm sorry. Yeah, LED faucet light. But there's other ones that are bigger or have cooler lights and stuff, but this one just does red. So you know when it's hot. So it's really, really kind of neat. Yeah, feel free to ask questions too, if I didn't say that. Okay. Let's start with the kitchen gadgets. Then we'll kind of move down the line here. One of the cool things we came across is the apple peeler or the potato peeler. Now, it's got the spikes on the end here, so you can set up a potato and just peel it. The suction cup sticks to the table, and then you could put the potato or the apple or anything. It just makes it really nice. You can do a one-handed peeling, or you can spin the crank and, you know, turn it around a little bit. So it's, if you have trouble, you know, with the actual, you know, holding the potato and peeling it, the like a potato peeler is awesome.
Yes.
Actually, I got it here. This was at the thing up in front. Yeah, so the souvenir shop. So the gift shop. Where you probably get it at any kitchen shop, any kitchen place, but this one actually we bought here. But it's an apple peeler. And I got the box. I can tell you where, you know, a more detailed thing on it. Now, one of our constant issues is opening containers, and this one is under the shelf thing, sort of mount like under the shelf like that. It's got a little groove and a little kind of knife. It's actually kind of sharp, actually. But if you just put a container in there and twist, it will pop the top off. So it's very nice. You don't have to get any of the grips, or it's adjustable. You know, you can actually do like a Pepsi bottle or a water bottle that's really small top, because this wedge thing in here is really, really kind of nice. So you can just twist that on anything without having to get all the extra grips. So it mounts right up under the counter. Now this one I have to thank Diane for. This is known as the Good Grip by OXO Company here. The little things that you can't normally cut up, tomatoes, grapes, strawberries, they have these little things. It's probably hard to see here, but you dump them into this container, and there's a groove. I'm just going to use the knife here just to kind of stick it in there to show you. But you can cut into it. You know, I mean, I'm not using the right kind of knife, but for the sake of the illustration, you can see the knife going through. So you can, instead of having to hold those things in your hand, you just cut them down, and they're pretty good. So I'll take that out of there for you, so it doesn't look too bad. If you like to have bagels and donuts, this is the bagel guillotine. It is. You know, probably came right from France. I don't know. You know, but you stick the donut or the bagel inside the slot and just put the blade down and push right in. It cuts right open. So it's a real easy, smooth cut. You don't have to worry about getting your fingers cut up or anything. One of my mom's favorites, and we found these usable, is the battery-operated can opener. Having use of only one hand, this thing works awesome. You just have to practice with it a bit, because this, when you hit the button, it spins the gadget thing, the locking mechanism thing, one way. But then when it gets done cutting, you have to hit the button that kind of spins it the other way to release the lock. So it takes a little bit to play around, but it's real easy to just put on.
Very convenient.
Yeah, very convenient. It's one hand. It's awesome. If you didn't want the, yes?
Will that open up the size 10 can? You know, the like a institutional size is size 10.
I think that would, because you've opened up coffee cans, right? So is that about the size 10?
Bigger?
Oh, yeah. I would think it would. I'd give it a shot. You know, if you got one we could open with, let's try it. Okay, well, if they got one in the back office here, let's go find one. Yeah, this is nice because there is definitely no sharp edges. Like my mom just said, it's all like a magnet. So, you know, you can, you know, stick your finger in pretty good without getting messed up.
They sell those at Targets for around $20.
Yeah, I think that's where I got it. It was like Target or Walmart. Most of the stuff up here across the board is under $20. And I can tell you where I found them as we go through here. This is a locking can opener. Let me hit that lock. You can see that there's a lock here, and when you put the can opener on, it just locks right on. So if you needed one can, if you're still one-handed or couldn't move it too easily, put the can up against like the table or the counter edge, and just one hand would twist it. It works great. So it locks it right on there pretty good. Now, yeah, getting all this stuff, most of this I got like Walmart, Target. I didn't go to any of the designer stores like at the Partridge Creek Mall or anything like that. So you can find it pretty easy. This is, let me try to open it here. There's a lock, there it goes. Salad tongs, clam tongs, so they call them clam tongs. And it's great for one-handed, like spaghetti, pasta, salad. Then you can pick it up one-handed and it, you know, it doesn't fall out. Then there's a locking button. So you put that lock in there and it'll usually stay shut. But of course, it's not going to do that right now. but yeah, it locks it right up for you. So yeah, if you wanted to put it away, it folds up fairly nice. You know, without that lock, it keeps popping open. You can't put it in the drawer. So you need to close it down and get it locked. This is what they call the single-handed cutting board. So this nice cutting board has suction cups on the bottom of it. And this little piece, let me try to pop it out here, has spikes on the bottom. So when you put it in there, if you needed to get like say an apple or potato, you can pop it on them little spikes and it'll stay there in place so you can peel it or cut it. And that comes right out. Also the regular cutting board. But this part, which is nice, let me put this here, is you can adjust to pretty much any size container with this little vice grip. Let me slide that in. So you slide it in, or what's hard to see from where you're at, there's a bunch of little holes along this board. So these little pegs move all over the place, so they fit whatever size container you really have. But like if you put like a container like that in, let's see. Let me slide that up. You know, it'll stay in place. Like if you needed to stir something or, you know, chop stuff, whatever, it's a really nice little feature for that. Yeah, highly recommend like a cutting board like this. It's like I said, it's for us, it works great, and the suction cups stick to everything. So that's why I put the towel on. I didn't want it to stick to the table. Now this odd little thing is a bread buttering or device. That's what they actually called it. Some kind of odd name the British people gave to it. It's hard to see, but there's like a raised lip over here. And let me just stick something there. I can say this. You can see that there's this raised lip. It keeps it from going. If you put a piece of bread in that, there's little suction cups on the back and that angled lip on the side. If you want to butter, make a peanut butter sandwich, it just puts everything right in place. So, and that does not move. It'll stay there. You know, if you put that down like that against the table, it'll stay there. So it's pretty nice. No questions there? Well, let's go to the next thing. My background is security. And I feel that part of it's like to give you a good idea of what security options are out there. I want you to be safe. I want you to be safe at home. I want you to be safe when you go out places. So I've put together some cool little devices for you that start out, think this way. And I know this is kind of weird to think. I'm going to hold it up too. If in case I miss it, security perceived is security achieved. That's kind of the model in security forces. When you're driving down the street and you see a police cruiser parked along the side of the road, you will slow down, right? Or stop. And you, as you drive by and you realize, hey, nobody was in it, you know, it did its job, right? So maybe the officers were doing something else or just set you up with a decoy car. But that, you know, you slowed down. That was what you did. So across the board, if people think you got security stuff, the safer you are. And that's what this whole idea is. I'm not trying to make you security experts. I just want to keep you a little safer. Some of the stuff, the cool things I came across are these two little alarms. This little alarm hooks onto the door handle of your house. And you turn it on, and when like somebody comes in, it jiggles the thing and it goes off. You do not want to hear this thing go off right now, trust me. But this one, I will be more than glad to turn on for you. This one goes under the door as a doorstop. And when something hits this metal plate, it pushes it down and the alarm goes off. These are great if you go traveling, you go in a hotel room or something. If you do travel, take the batteries out before you go. You know, the airport people do not like that. So I would take the batteries out, but these are perfect to keep you safe at a hotel or something or at your house. For the sake of this, I will turn this one on. It's loud, so give me a second here. And I'll turn it right off real quick. I just want you just to know that these things will scare somebody away. So ready? Cover your ears, you need them. Yeah, it's, you wouldn't think that that little guy would have an alarm like that, but it does. So it's, to me,
where could you get that?
These Menards up at Chesterfield at Hall Road there, got them at the home security aisle. So I'll have to say Menards, because these are only like $5 or $6. They're not expensive. They're really nice, like $5 to $6. I think I paid $6 for this guy, you know, so. The door wedge alarm. It's really what it's called, like the door wedge alarm. So, you know, they're not getting creative with the names. You know, we want to sell them to you, I guess, but it's just, you know, it's just, because all it is just, you know, like the normal you'd have like a rubber door wedge to keep the door shut. That's all this thing is, but it's, you know, metal. So, I got a whole series of alarms here. If you don't want to hear those cool sounds, and you just want to keep yourself safe, get yourself a little wooden wind chime. Hang it on the door handle. Somebody comes in at night, you'll hear that thing jiggling around. With security, you don't have to be, you know, spend a lot of money. You know, that unfortunately, that's the lie the business likes to sell you. You know, like you got to buy this monthly security fee, you got to buy this high-end stuff. You don't. This little wood chime thing was $1 at the dollar store. You know, so I went with the wood because, you know, the porcelain ones would jiggle too much and may break. But the wood, you can hear that. These are what they call personal safety alarms. These are keychain alarms, which is really cool. If you went to travel, like say, you know, you go just walk in the park and you fell. You know, let's not even think being attacked or nothing like that. I'm not trying to scare you on that end. But you fell, and you needed something to, you know, you wanted somebody to get somebody's attention. These alarms will get your attention, you know. So, like, this is one of them. I'm gonna pull it. Get ready, if you. They're loud. So, it's loud enough to get somebody's attention. And the nice thing is, these things are only a couple dollars. They're not expensive. You put them on your keychains, or this one's a necklace or something, and yes, actually, I got them all at Menards, with the exception of these two guys here, because
all in the same department.
Yes, they were in the home security aisle at Menards. When you saw the motion lights and everything, and then there was like a little end cap of these things that had all this stuff all right next to each other. So, and the problem though with these alarms, and I'm telling you, I love these things, you know, because they're great for all aspects. If you're at your house, for instance, and you fell, you can pull it and throw that thing by the door. You know, maybe the neighbors would hear you outside or something, you know, something to get somebody else's attention to help you out. You know, so it's not, I don't want to scare you thinking, attack or, you know, someone breaking in your house. These just help on all aspects. But you can see with these two, the problem with these two things, and the security industry is realizing this, is no matter how cool we paint them or make them look, they still look like alarms. So, and guys probably don't mind, but you know, women, you like to accessorize your stuff with purses and stuff, so yeah. You're not gonna wear an alarm like that, but you would wear a little heart keychain. Mm-hmm. Or the little teddy bear. And I mean, I know this guy doesn't seem like he's an alarm, but he really is. Yeah, good backpack, you got kids going to school, you've got, you know, you just want to walk around. They're really nice. And I would recommend the, well, let's see. We were asked, how loud is the red one? So, yeah, so there's a little on and off switch outside, you know, so that it basically locks it in. I'll tell you, these things are great because, one of the things, like I say, I like to, you know, tell people about these because I see a lot of our college girls wearing them. I work for a college, and they went with the jewelry line. You know, there's a lot of cool little jewelry pieces, if you would. I just like the red heart, so I got, you know, thought that would make it look better. This little teddy bear, one of the cool things with this teddy bear, and now the heart and the teddy bear, they're both about $15. So, we had to order them because I couldn't find too many companies that actually made them. But the teddy bear has a computer app built into them. So if you, like, say, went out and fell, for instance, and you pulled the pin, wherever that guy's at, there's like a GPS locator in him, that locator will go to somebody's phone. So whoever you program his phone in. So like, say a neighbor checks in on you, or... You know, if your kids are in school or something, to go to their parents or whatever. So when you get him, all the directions are in the box of, well, how do you got to get that thing to go to someone's phone. And actually, you could do two people's phones, so like the parents or whoever. So it's really kind of a neat deal. Like I said, I like him because it's probably more for the parents. You know, the little kids will put a little teddy bear on their backpack or their keychain. But it's still, these are very cool, affordable things. Now, this one, if you're traveling, and this is going to be hard to see. This is a luggage strap, and it's actually a TSA approved luggage strap, which I think that means they can open it up because there's a key thing on there that says TSA lock, and they didn't give me the key, so I think they can open your luggage when you go in instead of cutting it up. But the nice thing is this has a combination lock on it, so when you get the combination, it opens up, or if not, it stays closed. And I know this may sound kind of odd, but I was thinking about this when, you know, if you're going on vacation or somewhere, take the strap and run it through the handles of your luggage, like at the hotel, and stick it like to the frame of the bed or the couch or something, you know, whatever you could stick it to. Because if somebody was going to run in and take your luggage, they're going to have to work for it. You know, I mean, I know they can cut this wire. I mean, this strap, it's not, you know, not that hard, but make them work for it, you know. And the idea of make them work for it, get fingerprints. When that's, you know, if they're working for it, they're getting fingerprints all over the place. They don't want to do that. So this little thing was about $10, and like I said, it's got a nice little combination lock on it. So if you mess up the combination, it won't open. So which is really cool. So I, you know, definitely nice little feature for, you know, traveling or around the house. Now, another couple ideas is to take little pouches. When you go out, you don't want to open your wallet or your purse and show that you got $500 in your purse if you're traveling or something, or your wallet, or if you've gone, you know, the nice experience of going to the airport, you never know what they're going to make you take out of that wallet. You know, so you put the stuff in a little, like, you know, shoulder bag or something that goes over, you know, that you could wear, that you could tuck under the, you know, your jacket or shirt. This one should be big enough to put a passport in there. So, and it's got like pockets and stuff inside there. So, you know, that you could put your passport, your plane tickets, that kind of stuff. Yes. Oh, yes. One of these little traveling packs. Same thing, is a little bigger than this, but, you know, either wears around the waist or wear around the shoulder or something. the idea of keep everything out of sight. You know, you don't want people to see what you got, you know. And, you know, and I like to keep it separated, you know, so that way I don't have to pull my wallet out, or if you're going through, I mean, well, anywhere, you know, people are watching, you know, you go to JCPenney or something, you know, and you buy something, put the $20 you're going to spend in that and pull that out instead of reaching for the big money stuff. So,
where'd you get that at?
Well, the fluorescent one here, I actually got at the dollar store. This one I picked up at some conference, so feel free to take them. I probably got a bunch of those around. Now, one of the ideals, like I said, security perceived is security achieved. If you don't feel comfortable with alarms and different things, and you just want to upgrade your house for just a couple dollars, there, you can get bigger stickers. This one says protected by Saber Security Systems. Now, they had yard signs and everything. This is all at Menards, but this came with the pack of five stickers. There's other ones back there if you know, feel free to take one. The table that's in the back over there, all that stuff's free to take. So, but yeah, you can put stickers in your window. If you use something like this, get something that looks real. Don't say protected by Bugs Bunny or the Roadrunner or something. You know, they're going to know that's probably fake. But, you know, something like this may stop them, you know. Because you remember, when they're looking, they want the easy opportunity. They don't want, you know, they don't want to go in and get, you know, caught on video or anything stupid. You know, they want to get in at your house easy. So little stickers. If you have a yard, get a big dog. And even if you don't have a big dog, still get a dog bone, a bigger toy, and throw it out in your yard. You know, to me, it's your security, it's your safety. There's no reason to lie. You know, they don't care if you're, you know, you put the sign up that says, beware a dog, I don't mind lying about it, you know. I want them thinking I got some dog that's going to tear them up if they jump in my yard. If you don't, try another one. Video security cameras in use. So these signs are great. They will, it gets people thinking, you know, for a lot of the stuff. You know, you just want them to stay away and pass by your house. So. I tell you, I came across an alarm. It was about $100. It's expensive, but instead of making these nice, cool little chimes and everything like this stuff did, it was dogs barking, and this thing was vicious. I mean, if somebody came in your house after hearing that thing go off, they better be in trouble. So. Now the other end, put that on, is fake cameras. And actually, you notice this one's just called a dummy camera. I bought this at Home Depot for like $3. This one doesn't work as well, but it works great. You know, if you put it out like in the corner, you would think this would be on. Actually, this one has, since it's not working right, there's batteries in it and little lights light up. So it makes it look so, you know, you can't tell it's not real. So you put one of these out, it will deter most people. You know, they don't want to be caught on camera. Fake cameras and security systems are great. Another way is lighting. And nowadays, there's so much cool lighting that you could put on. This is the one we use. Hopefully it comes on here. There it goes. This is a solar power motion light. Doesn't require any wiring. The solar cell charges itself up. And you can, you know, it comes on. You can tape it to the wall, or this one has like one screw. It goes in, so you can put these things all over the place. And this was about $15, so it wasn't too bad. I actually got this at like CVS, one of those the as seen on TV section rolls. So these are really nice. Like I said, and the idea is put what you can out. You know, you don't have to go a lot of, you know, expensive stuff. Just a little extra lighting outside, like this guy over here, is one of those light sticks. He's a solar power light stick. Let's see if we can get him to work. Is he working? He's kind of working. He's not a bright light. This one's not a bright light. This is a yard light, one of those, you know, you get a whole bunch of them. I picked it up at the dollar store. So just, you know, there's a lot of nice, affordable extra lighting system that doesn't require an electrician to come in and wire up your house. So if you need, you know, little lighting by the driveway or the stairs. These little things work great. Or that guy right there. So a lot of good, affordable opportunities nowadays.
Where was Garden State?
No, the Dollar Tree. So, yeah, so I have to, I'll give them credit because I do buy a lot of stuff from them because they come up with some really cool stuff. And actually a lot of them, I'd say most of the stuff you could find at Dollar Tree or Five Below. If you haven't been to those Five Belows, yeah, everything $5 and under, it's great. So most of the stuff is very affordable for you. This is a nice little LED flashlight, and it's really bright, and you can see it does a couple things, like flashes, and you know, so if you're in distress, you can wave it, or if you just need it as a flashlight. It's extremely lightweight. I mean, it's nice. What to me, you don't have to carry that big bulky flashlight, you know, with the four D-cell batteries in it anymore. You can just get yourself a nice little thing like that, and it's just as bright, if not brighter, than those things were. And I guess the last thing on the security in here, and we're going to try to make this work really cool for you. Okay. This is a digital doorbell. So this thing in my right hand here, this little thing, is the peephole. You know, set it to, you know, if you have a door with the peephole on it, you can pull it out and put this little thing in it. So, can you see? Hopefully you guys can see yourselves on here or see something. You know, the screen itself is about the size of a cell phone. And, you know, you'll be able to see who comes up. If they hit it, it rings. And actually, this has got some crazy sounds. Like, let's come back on. So you can see whoever comes up. You could program different tunes on here. Let's see. There we go. But it's got Christmas stuff. Of course, it's not going to go now. But but it does work. It's a really cool deal that it gives you a good panoramic view outside. You could see how kind of wide the view is. So it's not just like looking out the little peephole. You can actually see a wider screen. This little thing I picked up at Menards for $20. So this is a digital peephole is what they call that thing. We'll get it to ring later, maybe. Of course, yes. Yes.
I have a question. Okay. Our front doors have a lot of glass panels, and they're double panel glass. But it would be a good idea to get a solid steel door with a peephole, or is that safe to have a door with so much glass in it?
No, you know, we have a door with so much, you know, glass and panels on both sides.
I mean, the door itself has a panel of glass. There's like 3, 6, 9 little panes of glass, and it's a double glass. Yeah. But that's a large area of glass. Can they break through a double glass panel and reach in and unlock the door?
You know, I don't want to scare you, but yeah, you know, anything they could, you know, anything's breakable or whatever. I don't want to scare you on that, but that way, maybe put other options. You get one of the cameras that you could put outside and see if they're out there. One of the key things is take the door open if you can, depending on what the space. Open the door, take that little brass plate where the deadbolt slides into, and put longer screws in there. Because the problem is those little screws are really itty bitty. You know, if you put longer screws, you know, if you got the wood frame there. Now, I mean, I don't want to say put 4-inch screws in, it's going into glass either. So, you know, ours has the glass window and the glass on the panel. So, we put a little longer, but not 4-inch screws. Anything, you know, buys you a couple seconds. That's what you're looking at. You're not looking at, you know, being stuck in your house for a year or something, you know, hoping these guys just keep banging the door and run away. You're looking at a couple seconds. That gets a 911 call. You know, that gets you something to pick up and say, you know what, you want to come in here, you're getting hit with a lamp or whatever. And I say, whatever comes at you, whatever you got, keys.
Baseball bat,
keys, shoes, anything. Throw it at them. You know, anything. It's not about taking them out. I'm not saying hit them with shoes is going to knock somebody out. It may make them turn and run. Or decide to think about coming in that house, you know. So, one of the training videos we did, it was a basically an active shooter going into an elementary school. And they had the kids throw their shoes at the guy when they came in. That's all these little kids. And this guy came running in, they just started throwing shoes at him. It didn't matter if it hurt him or not. It was enough to get him to thinking. And once he stopped, you know, the teachers and whoever else were in, the adults were in the room, were able to tackle that guy. So, yeah, anything you got around you becomes a weapon. I'd have to say that, you know. So if they're coming in and they're kicking them with glass open, throw something at them. Hit them with something, you know. You got a baseball bat, you know. It's, you know, use it to your advantage. I mean, you know, it buys you 3 seconds, that's a 911 call. You know, so that's all, you know, that's what you're looking at down the line. You know, hopefully the emergency responders get to that and you're good. You know, so, you know, you're buying seconds, not buying hours or days. You're just, you know, just enough to get somebody else here to get, you know, get you help. So that's, you know, that's what you need to look at. Any other questions with the security stuff? Well, this is great. We're moving right on through. All right. Couple of things, and I've been finding these lights, and I've been loving them. Just, you know, there's some great options that are really nice and bright that are not, you know, you don't have to require an electrician to get you or anything. For instance, this cool little light switch, and it just has a magnet on one side and tape. You know, so if you want to tape it, if I wanted to put it right there and have a fake light switch, it looks good. But when you flick the light switch, it's just turns, it's really bright, actually, when you turn that on. So it's nice to set up something else, you know, like say if you need it in the garage or the basement or whatever, or just for a couple emergency lights. You know, if you wanted to have a couple of these things laying around the house for...
A closet.
Yeah, you know, closet stuff, definitely good for it. You know, so places where you don't need an electrician to come in and pay. This little guy was $3 at Menards. So... No, it's got some batteries in it, but this one's battery operated, yes. Now, this one is the Night Angel. If you haven't seen this guy, this thing, I'm really impressed by this. Let's see if we got a plug. What this is a light switch plug. And all you got to do is take the one screw out of the middle of the light switch that you have, like, on the wall over there. Take the cover off and put this guy on. No wiring is required. There's inside there, there's actually like two prongs that fit on the existing light switch thing, the screws. And there's four lights on the bottom. So it's really nice. There's a motion light and that. Yes, Diane.
Well, it says on the package that you have to turn off your circuit breaker for that. Do you really have to, or do they just say that to cover their own stuff?
You know, I would. I mean, I don't like to get shocked too much. I mean, but I'm going to tell you, the guy right behind you is the guy who would turn it back on for me, so I do get shocked. That's my brother back there. So, or my aunt and my uncle who are sitting back there, they would do it too. I would say turn it off, all honesty. It takes a couple seconds, but this is nice because you really can't see it from up here, but there's a little motion light and these three little night lights. Well, this one's got three, I'm sorry. Night lights, so when you walk by at night, you don't have to, they just come on. You don't have to fumble for the little night lights around the house. It also does, it frees up your two plugs. So, you know, if you know, normally a night light takes at least one plug up, so this frees them up. So it's a great thing for like the kids' rooms or, you know, the closets or the whatever, you know, too, so they'll light up, or like a stairwell. That was Rite Aid. It was in the As Seen on TV section in Rite Aid. And that was only like $10, so. It's a nice deal. It's a, you know, I like that little guy. This is a really long extension cord with an on and off button, push button on it. Now, I got all these stuff plugged in, so I'm not going to mess with these real quick. But the if you have, you know, like the lights with the little light switches, or, you know, like the light, you know, you have to twist in there, you can't reach in there, or something else that's pretty hard to reach. Use one of these cords that you just plug into the wall, and the other end plugs into that light, the cord for the light. That way you can just use the button to turn it on and off instead of, you know, that little twist thing on the lights. So it's really nice. We have, you know, a few of those around the house, and it's really, really well. I think I got this at Menards, but, you know, pretty much any hardware store has some version of these, you know, that work there. Now, one of the coolest, fun ones that I found here, and hopefully you're going to be able to see this here, is the cell phone screen magnifier. Oh, So, oh, Siri here might be talking to us. This is, I'm using my mouse phone. Can you see the screen? I don't know. Just wait. Let me. Okay, you might be able to see the screen. You put your cell phone on this little shelf behind it, and it so you could it magnifies it on the big screen there, just about three times the size. It's not that big. Yeah, three times the size of the screen, but you could read it from probably way out there, and or if you're watching movies or something. The nice thing is with this, this was only $5 at Walmart. So, and it, when you're done with it, it just folds down. So you could put it in the purse, hide it in the drawer, or whatever. So that this little thing is really nice because that way, you could read it from a distance. If somebody's calling you or whatever, you'd be able to see it from a distance. Any questions so far? This weird looking little device is what. Yeah, they're shackles. This thing is called the Clamp Champion. Now, what this is, I'm going to use my mouse cell phone here again. It locks a cell phone or like a tablet. I got the tablet mounted over there into place. And you could put the bottom part like on your leg. You know, if you wanted to, this thing turns all over the place. So if you wanted to angle it your way, you can see it turns, or it actually comes off. It's like if you wanted just the top part, like one of the things they're showing, the top circle fits on the car visor. So your car, when you're driving your hands-free phone. But like this part, you can hook like on the arm of a couch, the arm or your leg. So you can sit there and basically operate it hands-free. You know, so it's pretty nice. It's this little device against the Clamp Champion. I had to order this one online, but it was only about $10. So it took a while to find something like that, but I could tell you where we got, I got everything back here to tell you where we got it. Now, one of the cool things, Diane gave me this here. When the soap, it gets, slippery and it slips out of your hand. Johnson's and Johnson's came up with the Johnson's Kids soap. And what this actually has, I'm going to open it here. It's a bar of soap inside a netting, a non-slip netting. So, you still soap up and stuff, but the stuff doesn't slide out of your hand. So, if you're looking for something different to help, it's the Johnson & Johnson's Kids Soap. So, it was a dollar? Yeah. At Kroger, because yeah. Diane gave me that one. So, yeah, she's the expert on where she got that. These couple things here are actually book, like, cushions, I guess, if you want. If you want to read a book or you put your phone or your tablet on, this, the phone or the book sits right in against this little stuffed animal thing here, and it has the book marker to come down. So, it's nice that if you wanted to, use it on your legs and stuff. So, unfortunately, most of the stuff has, solid legs. If you were, a little table kind of thing or some stand that has legs that we're going to, if you're trying to sit in a chair and read a book, it's hard to maneuver. But this is called the book pillow. And, that it, like I said, fits in with the bookmark. This is also a book stand, and so is that yellow wedge there. Got these at the Foam Factory. The Foam Factory moved. They were on Hall Road and basically Grosbeck. Now they're at 23 and Romeo Plank. So, but these are only a couple dollars. You can go walking in their factory. It's open to the public, and they've got a ton of different kind of these little book stands and different things. So if you wanted to, read a book in the, this may not be as comfortable as that, but it's all foam. It's not, you don't have legs or table stand legs or sticking in here or something. This is the laptop desk. Probably one of my mom's favorite, most used gadgets. Unlike most table things, have little legs, and if you're eating on them, they never ever bounce, right? But this has like a beanbag thing on the bottom. So you could kind of, it flattens out and works out, so it bounces out pretty good. So it's pretty comfortable. She can tell you she uses it all the time. So it bounces itself. So it's really nice to eat or do stuff. Any questions, anything so far? All right, we'll keep on moving on. Are they on? Okay, good. This little device is another security device, but since I had to plug them in, I'll put it down here. This, I know it's going to be really hard to see. I'm going to go through, there's a bunch of little lights flickering on in there. And what this does is simulates a fake TV. So if you're going to be gone, like, for a long period of time or something, or go on vacation, and you know how the TV, you see it through the window, it's got all the, you know, it's, you know, that's what this little thing's doing. It looks like a big screen TV, like projected on your wall at night, but it's flashing a whole, well, it's programmable with a bunch of different things. It's, let's see, I'm trying to get it to come up with some of the better patterns here, but you could, it just keeps flashing around. So it's programmable by time, like how long you want it on, but also the size you want it to be. So you know, if somebody's walking by, they're gonna say, oh, the TV's going, somebody's there. You know, so that's what, you know. So it's really kind of neat. This little fake TV was $15, so. Now we're gonna get into some of the fitness stuff in just the general fun stuff here, I think. One of the things, highly recommend non-slip shelf liner. You know, got this at the dollar store. You can, you know, line the shelves obviously with this, but you can cut this stuff down and use it to open tops, you know, so. It makes a really easy grip for you. If you take it, and let me just show you here. You take it and you wrap it around like the jar or whatever. Just, you know, and I would cut it down to different sizes. Obviously, I'm just using an old roll. But if you wrapped it around and it makes that thing not slip, put it in a drawer and just. Let's just say here's the drawer, you just close the drawer in front of it. So that you're using your weight against the drawer to kind of keep the bottle there, and it just pops right open, the top pops right open. So that you could both, you know, both works on the top and the side. So definitely recommend any of the non-slip shelf line. I mean, got that at the dollar store again, so it's real affordable. This little oddball convenience thing, it's hard to see, is the car cane. This prong sticks into the hook of the door when you open your car door, and where the thing locks back in. You stick that prong in, and it gives you a little handle to get up. So it does work great to help you out. It's balanced in there pretty good. The thing is, if you forget this is in there and you close the door, it will mess up your door. I'll give you that warning ahead of time, but it really is a good little handle, because when you're getting out of the car, the door locks like right about there, you know, so it gives you that extra boost, so you don't have to reach up and pull that those handles off the ceiling. This also has a little built-in flashlight to it. The prong is tipped to bust out a window if you got in a car accident, and also on the end of it has a seatbelt cutter, so it really is a good multi-personal tool if you need it. It's worth throwing it in the glove box and have an emergency tool, even if you don't use it for the handle. But like I say, if you left this thing in and that door got closed, it will mess up your door. So I was kind of playing around. I didn't mess up my door. But I wanted to see if it would like pop open. You know, like if the door hit it, if it would knock the thing loose. It didn't. It stayed right in it. So right at the as seen on TV aisle at CVS. This is a plug timer. You know, so you know if you're going to be gone, or you know want something at night to just your lights to turn on and stuff. Turn, you know, get one of these. It's great to, you know, have a light turn on so that if you come in at, you know, at 8 o'clock at night, the house isn't dark or something. So you can pre-program it for yourself, but you can pre-program it if you're going to be gone. You know, so again, if somebody's watching the house, you want to make them think people are there. So a little, nice little timer. Jump over here. A lot of the stuff is the fitness stuff, I think, and I'm not saying getting on a fitness program, you know, just start off stuff, but you know, definitely got to check it with your doctor first, but before you do anything. But if you're interested in like some of these resistance things, I got these two sets at the Five and Below store, so, and they're really good quality. I was surprised because they're like stretchable tubes, you know, that you could do a good workout. And I'm going to guess that's probably about 20 pounds or so of pressure on that one. And that one's that's probably about the same, a little, maybe 25. So it's a good workout. If you're wanting to get a workout in, I was surprised at Five Below that these things were that good of quality, to be honest. So instead of having to go out and buy a really high-end home gym, these things were pretty good. And also you can get these, like the light resistance bands. You know, it's a good workout here with that. If you feel you need higher level bands, I got bands that go up to 100 pounds. So, MC Sports at the Lakeside Mall. That's where I bought them. You know, so I mean, they vary from maybe a half a pound to 100 pounds. So, wherever you're at in the, working out, don't give up or anything. Feel free to get other sets. Like if you bought the traveling set, usually go about $20, $20 to $30. They come with the multiple resistance levels, so that you like two, five, ten, or whatever they come up to. But a lot of those have a hook that you can add the belts to it, to the handle, instead of just this one's kind of mounted in there. But I don't know. Let's see if it feels. I think if you double it over, it should feel. Yeah, it feels a little tougher. I mean, it does add a little resistance. Whether it works out to be double, I'm not sure, but it does give you a good workout. And like I say, for $5, I was really amazed. I was, I was kind of worried. I put them through the test to make sure they weren't going to break. I wanted to make sure I wasn't going to recommend some for $5. Yes.
Do you use any of those?
Yeah, the ones I have, like I said, I have one as a 100 pound and a 50 pound one. My brother's laughing. We have them. Let's say I haven't used them. I have the thing also mounts on the door, and when you pull the door likes to bend a little bit. So, but I have them, and he has them too. So we have the ones that have the adjustable bands that go up higher. So mine, like I said, I have one that goes on up to 100. Now this thing here is the leg exerciser. Now you may be able to see it from back there. I'll see if I can hold it up here. It is the pedals move on their own. So it gives you a great workout if you can't operate, a lot of the stuff like the pedal bikes, if you pedal, your foot falls off the pedal or something. This is flat. I mean, it's got legs on the bottom, so I can lay it flat. But you can just put your feet on it and it goes on its own. Like this thing here is called the foot stepper. And you can see it's got these little feet, and if you hit them, but you have to hit, be able to operate both feet with them. Or if you push one down, it won't, unless you're just alternating one foot per pedal. The nice thing with this little thing, both of these I had to order online. This is expensive. I only found it in one place, and it was about $150. This little thing folds up, and the piece puts in there, and it goes right in. And then you can take it with you real easy. So this thing was like $9. So I had ordered. This is called the foot stepper. There is no tension on this thing. This thing increases the speed here. So it does go a little faster. There's no real tension on that. It just moves on its own, but goes faster or slow. This one has no tension. This is like a little thing that just kind of like teeter-totters back and forth that's inside there. One of the necessities to have is the hand tool grabber thing. These things, you can get them up to $40, $50. I mean, I found some pretty expensive ones. Some fold up and, depending on what you want to do with them. Just for the sake of the illustration, I got this at the dollar store. So it's actually pretty good. It'll get you around for a bit. I mean, I'm not saying this is the guy you want to have all the time, but if you needed something to pinch, the dollar store version is really good. Now, one of the things, let me turn that off. I want you to remember, I guess, you can still have fun. I mean, I know things, maybe get hard to pick up or different things, but you can still find stuff. And I like games. If you like to play games, here's the Jumbo Checkers. I mean, this thing, let me grab a checker. The checkers are huge, and they're really thick. So, the board is, how big is the board? The board is 3 feet by 3 feet. So Yeah, it's a great way to keep painting. Cause one of the things I really looked into. I think a lot of times you say, oh, I have to give up because I can't pick up the cards or whatever. Nah, have fun with it. Find what works for you. You know, if you like to play cards, these things are huge. You know, if you need a bigger, I did find a bigger. This was the medium size that I found.
Okay, I'll get something about that. We play rummy and we hold 10 to 11 cards. I can see myself
holding those. Oh, yeah, they're great. You can easily hold 12 cards, you know. But and I brought them also as a joke, but really, you know, there are stuff out there. If you're looking at, if you like to play games, don't give up on the games. You know, there's Connect Four. We found big sets of Connect Four or Yard. You know, look under Yard versions or like party versions of them. They had larger sizes of Uno cards, regular cards, stuff like that. So there's a lot of options out there. Get the card holders. You know, if you can get a whole bunch of those card holders to play them. I found dominoes that were really big dominoes, if you like to play dominoes. My mom has the automatic card shuffler, so she can play solitaire. Yeah, that's perfect, because your hands, you can't use it. Just put the thing in the machine, it shuffles it right up for you. So the last couple things are these two stands. This is a hairdryer stand, and it adjusts higher here. Let me show you. So it's pretty good. This thing was about $15. I had ordered it online, but we found a version of it at Sally's Beauty Supply. So they might have something like that. But I would say if you get something like this, get the ones with the floor stands. These both have, this has, I'm using it on a table, but there's a stand on the bottom, so it stands on its own. The original one we had suction cups that stuck to the wall. And after a little bit, the hair dryer was too heavy to keep it up in the wall, so it kept falling off. But so I would say for the same price as the one we paid for the suction cups, the stand works great. Now this is, this little thing is the, like a tablet stand or a phone. On the back here, there's a bracket that adjusts. So you could put a phone up here, but if you want to play like your video games or you're doing your work, it just flexes all over the place. So it's nice for my mom to sit in a chair. She can turn that thing all around the place and it stays in place. Again, this thing, I would say get the floor stand, because there was options that had a bracket that mounted on your table or like a cabinet or something, like a jaw. That's going to tear your cabinet up pretty soon. And you realize how heavy this really is when you move it around. So this has got a big floor stand, as you can see in the back there. So it's I would go for the floor stand. This I found online. You have to look. If you get any kind of stands, there's a ton of them. You know, find out what works for you. You know, some have little legs, some have the flexible arms, whatever works for you. There's a ton of stuff. So, you know, do your research on that. But like if you went to Five and Below, they had a whole bunch of them that gave you an option to see what you might want. So, yeah, I think we covered everything. All right, any questions? So thank you for coming out here. And I guess we got 2 o'clock, so thank you.